Welcome to episode 212, Thomas Frist Jr., the founding and history of HCA. This is an outline of episode 212. There are three reasons why we study Thomas Frist Jr. First, he's the second richest doctor in the world. Second, he's the richest man in Tennessee. Third, he co-founded HCA, the largest for-profit hospital chain in the world.
He was the first. He was the one who had the original vision.
Thomas Frist Jr. was born in Nashville, Tennessee in 1938, the eldest son of a prominent cardiologist, Thomas Frist Sr. He was a quarterback in high school and studied pre-med at Vanderbilt University. In 1965, he earned a medical degree from Washington University, St. Louis. He was 27. Next, Thomas Frist served as a flight surgeon in the United States Air Force. In 1968, Thomas Frist Jr., his father Thomas Frist Sr., and Jack C. Macy co-founded HCA in Nashville, Tennessee. Here's a picture of the three co-founders.
Milton Johnson is the CEO of HCA. The first hospital that HCA owned was Parkview Hospital, near downtown Nashville.
This is a picture of Parkview Hospital, the first hospital to join HCA. Parkview Hospital was started by Dr. Thomas Frist Sr. in 1960. Question: how did a young Thomas Frist Jr. at age 30, with no business experience and fresh with an MD, build the world's largest for-profit hospital chain? And why in Nashville? I become curious.
But some medicine, I just never thought that I'd do anything other than that. I had other goals that I thought the medicine would give me a platform of which to achieve in my life. It turned out, because of other influence of Mr. Massey, who you see his name out here, Jack Massey, he's a piece of my father's. And he bought Kentucky Fried Chicken while I was young in college. And before it ever went public, and he would give a few shares to my parents, but he'd give them to the children rather than my mother and father. Well, I just watched that. And I'd go and thank Mr. Massey back when I was in college, and then medical school, and all of a sudden the stock came public, did great things. But Mr. Massey, without knowing it, said he became a role model in many ways, because he was a very successful entrepreneurial business person. So I sat there and watched him, and he would give things back that many entrepreneurs wouldn't have made thought from a loose the next day. It's very generous and so profit.
Jack Massey is one of America's most famous entrepreneurs. In 1964, he paid Colonel Sanders $2 million for KFC. Jack Massey would make hundreds of millions of dollars from Kentucky Fried Chicken. Thomas Frist Jr.'s vision for a profit hospital came from scale and economy. He got this from Kemmons Wilson, the founder of Holiday Inn in Memphis, Tennessee.
It's time to think during the Vietnam War, and I realized there were 4,000 hospitals independently operated as a cottage industry, while Kroger's and various things that reorganized into a more efficient, productive type of vehicle. And then I remember a fraternity brother of mine at Vanderbilt's father. It started Holiday Inns of America and changed what we used to do when I traveled to Florida, staying in a hotel or somebody's guest house going to Florida. I found out he changed, and they actually started calling hotels, called hotels. Motor cars, other hotels. Changed the whole leisure field.
The small group of founders worked out of a small house not far from Parkview for the first few years of operation. In 1969, HCA conducted its first initial public offering on the New York Stock Exchange. During the 1970s and 1980s, the corporation went through a tremendous growth period, acquiring hundreds of hospitals across the United States, which numbered 255 owned and 208 which HCA managed.
In 1993, HCA merged with Columbia Healthcare of Louisville, Kentucky to form Columbia HCA. And then trouble, big trouble ahead.
In 1993, HCA merged with Louisville-based Columbia Hospital Corporation to form Columbia HCA. In April 1998, Birmingham, Alabama-based HealthSouth Corporation announced it was acquiring the majority of HCA's surgical division. Fraud and investigation. In 1997, the company was part of a fraud investigation initiated by a number of governmental departments in the United States. Later that year, Rick Scott resigned as chairman.
Scandal and fraud.
On March 19, 1997, investigators from the FBI, the Internal Revenue Service and the Department of Health and Human Services served search warrants at Columbia HCA facilities in El Paso and on dozens of doctors with suspected ties to the company. He was paid a settlement of $9.88 million and left with 10 million shares of stock worth over $350 million, mostly from his initial investment. HCA also admitted fraudulently billing Medicare and other health programs by inflating the seriousness of diagnoses and to giving doctors partnerships and company hospitals as a kickbacks for the doctors referring patients to HCA. They filed false cost reports, fraudulently billing Medicare for home health care workers, and paid kickbacks in the sale of home health agencies and to doctors to refer patients. In addition, they gave doctors loans never intended to be repaid, free rent, free office furniture, and free drugs from hospital pharmacies. After Scott stepped down, Frist Jr. returned as chairman and CEO. The case was settled in 2002 at a reported cost of $2 billion to HCA. This made it the largest fraud settlement in U.S. history.
More settlement with the U.S. government over fraud in the amount of $600 million in 2002.
He called on longtime friend and colleague Jacko Borvinder, Jr. to help him turn the company around. Frist and Borvinder, who became CEO in 2001, pulled off what Fortune magazine called a remarkable corporate rescue. In settlements reached in 2000 and 2002, Columbia HCA pleaded guilty to 14 felonies. They admitted systematically overcharging the government by claiming marketing costs as reimbursable, striking illegal deals with home care agencies. In late 2002, HCA agreed to pay the U.S. government $631 million, plus interest.
In 1998, Thomas Frist Sr. died at the age of 87. In 2006, he took HCA private for $21 billion. The 2006 buyout of HCA was the largest private equity deal in history. In 2017, HCA is the world's largest for-profit hospital chain, with 177 hospitals and 119 surgical centers in the United States and in UK. HCA employs about 250,000 people, and it is said that 5% of U.S. healthcare spending is through HCA. What have I learned today? First, at age 30, Thomas Frist Jr. co-founded HCA with his father and Jack Macy. Second, HCA went through rapid change from 1 to over 300 hospitals. Third, and scandal and fraud ran rampant, and HCA paid more than $2.5 billion for settlement. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and leave your questions and comments below. My next video will be Thomas Frist Jr., builder of the world's largest for-profit hospital chain. 8 lessons. Wishing everyone peace and prosperity.